Hi everybody, we're just about at the end of Kinetics here. This is probably going to be our second to last video where we're going to finally quantify all these different factors that we have that affect rate. And the way they get quantified is they get quantified into a concept that's referred to as the Arrhenius equation. This is the same Arrhenius from acid-base theories that you've learned about before. So where did we get to this point? We talked about the collision model, which tells us that we have to account for the fact that molecules have to collide with some frequency. The more they collide, the faster the reaction. And they have to collide in the right orientation. We talked about things like expo markers and the fact that molecules have a particular shape and symmetry, and that's going to affect the rate at which they can react. We know about activation energy, the height of the hill. The taller the hill, the slower the reaction. And of course, temperature, the higher the temperature, the faster the molecules can react because they're colliding more frequently, they're colliding harder. And so they have more energy to get over the activation barrier. So we're going to finally go ahead and quantify all of these different concepts here. And it gets all of these guys get quantified into this thing called the Arrhenius equation. So I'm just going to go ahead and grab this image here, because this is where we're going to put in all of our variables. So we know about rate laws, and we know that rate is equal to the rate constant times the concentration of the reactants. I've got here A and B, and maybe we've got some reaction that is, I don't know, second order with respect to A, and first order with respect to B. So we know how concentration affects this hypothetical rate, and then all of these other values, how do they affect rate? Well, as we've been alluding to several times already, they're all buried inside of K. Now let's show you exactly how they're buried inside of K. So the rate constant K is going to be equal to the number of times molecules can collide with one another. This is going to be called the collision frequency, and it's typically represented with the letter Z. So Z is the collision frequency. It's going to account for the orientation of the molecules. This is a factor that's typically denoted with the letter P, and it's called the steric factor, S-T-E-R-I-C, the steric factor. And usually, these two ideas are put together, and we'll see that in a second. But the next term is where we're going to get activation energy and temperature, and that comes in the form of an exponential. You remember how rates often have these exponential shapes? So there is an exponential function here. So we have e raised to the negative of the activation energy, Ea, divided by Rt. We see that Rt value often. So R being the universal gas constant, and you're going to want to put it in the units of joules per Kelvin mole. So it's typically going to go in as 8.314. And the temperature, of course, is going to be in Kelvin. So here we see how all of these different factors that affect rate, activation energy, temperature, collision frequency, orientation, all arrive at influencing the rate. Okay, this is called the Arrhenius equation. And as I alluded to a few seconds ago, Z and P are usually packaged together into a value called A. Okay, that's the Arrhenius factor. Don't confuse this A with the kind of placeholder concentration A we used for the integrated rate law. It's a different value. So we have A, E to the negative EA over RT. This is the most common form you will see the Arrhenius equation represented. Okay, let's play around with this a little bit. I'm gonna shrink this guy down and I'm gonna get him out of the way. I'll just go ahead and delete those, that 2 and the 1. We don't really need those. We can play around with this equation a little bit. That equation in the red box, okay, for K, I can rearrange that. I can take the natural logs of both sides. So I could have the natural log of K is equal to negative EA over RT plus the natural log of the Arrhenius factor A. This hopefully looks a little familiar to you, this form of an equation. I have a y variable here, an x variable of 1 over t. Remember, activation energy is a constant for a reaction. R is a constant. and the Arrhenius factor will also be a constant. So this is y equals mx plus b, so that if you were to graph the natural log of k on the x-axis versus 1 over t on the, natural log of k on the y-axis and 1 over t on the x-axis, you would get a straight line with a negative slope, which you could then correlate back to Ea over R, so you could arrive at an activation energy. So what you do is you run the same reaction over and over and over again at different temperatures. So the different temperatures will give different values of K. Plot all those values of K versus those values of temperature, and you can isolate the activation energy. One more thing I want to show you that should also look familiar. Let's say you don't have all the values of K you want. You don't have enough to plot out a really accurate graph. Let's say that you only have two values of K at two different temperatures, at two different Ts. Could you arrive at a reasonable value of the activation energy? You could if you used an equation that looks like this. Natural log of little k2 over little k1 is equal to Ea over R times 1 over t1 minus 1 over t2. Now, I'm going to go ahead and put this guy in a big red box. This should look familiar. We saw a very similar equation to this when we worked with equilibrium constants and delta H's in the thermodynamics unit. Then we had a ratio of equilibrium constants, the reciprocal difference of temperatures, and we had delta H over R. Here we've got the ratio of rate constants, the reciprocal difference in temperature, and activation energy divided by R. Very similar setup. So the best way to get activation energies is to plot a whole bunch of data together to get a graph. But if you don't have that, you could at least go ahead and get it algebraically with a ratio of k's and t's. So this all comes out of the Arrhenius equation. Okay? That's all for now. We've got one more video on catalysis. We'll get to that later.